Hi, I'm Doug from the product team here at Sophos, and today we're going to be taking a look at how to create custom dashboards in Sophos Central. So, the default dashboard we've got here is great. We like it. But I'd like to create a custom dashboard optimized to my workflow. We'll just click Dashboards up top, then Manage Dashboards. We've got the central dashboard here, created by Sophos and set as default. Let's click Create New. Give it a name and optionally a description, and then click Next. And we've got a blank canvas to play with here. Now, all the widgets you see in the left-hand column here are available based on the license associated with your account. So if it's there, you can use it. I've got an XDR license, which of course also includes an endpoint license. So I'm going to filter by XDR and build myself a dashboard to keep an eye on my cases. I want to see my total cases, of course, so I'm going to drag that into the first position here. And I'm a stickler for efficient design, so I'm going to gleefully resize it to take up only half the width. And notice that all the data is populating on the widgets as well as I drag them into place. I also want to see my alerts, and I like the width of that one already, so I can just leave it be. And then I'm really interested in keeping an eye on my devices and threats, so I can further filter by XDR category. The account health summary widget is important, so I'm going to position that in the upper right. And I want to see my device health status as well, so I'll slide that in right underneath. And then I want total detections as well. And I like that it's a nice wide widget, so I've got that along the bottom here. But I can't, in good conscience, leave any blank space, efficient design and all. So I'm going to expand the alerts widget to take up the dead space. Phew, much better. Let's add some MITRE tactics, techniques, and procedures, and some sensor location data. And we've got a pretty handsome dashboard worked up here. Let's see how it all comes together by clicking the Done button. I'm going to set this as my default dashboard by clicking its respective radio button, and then clicking on the dashboard name will load it up for me. Okay, that's looking really good. Now I can customize it a bit more by, for instance, changing the date range of my total case count widget, showing only endpoint alerts, and filtering device health status by only computers. So if I click on just the critical devices here, it'll load up only computers in the critical state. And since I've set this dashboard as default, when I click on the Sophos logo, I'm sent back to my custom dashboard. And all the widget-based filters I set a moment ago are still the same. Now I like this dashboard. I can even click this arrow icon here to export it as a PDF file. But I think I want to add some firewall widgets to it as well. All I need to do is click the little edit pencil icon, and it'll pop me back into the dashboard editor. I can now filter by firewall and get a selection of firewall-only widgets to play with. The little blue dots on the widgets signify that they're new to the dashboard editor in the past few weeks, so I'm going to go ahead and add these two newest firewall widgets to my design. I could drag them into the bottom of the editor, or just click the little plus icon to add them in the next available slot. Again, no blank space, please and thank you. So I'll do a quick resize of each, and I'll be on my way. Click Done, and there's my beautiful dashboard, now with the two firewall widgets as well. So that's how to build a custom dashboard from scratch, but we also provide some pre-built dashboards you can customize as well. You can click the Find Dashboards button to see what's available. We've got a great Threat Analysis Center dashboard to get you started. So to do so, click the clone icon up here to make a copy of it. Give it a good name, and then click the clone button. I'll just resize this top widget real quick to make room for the total cases widget, which I'll size accordingly and slide into place. Click Done, and we've got a customized Threat Analysis Center dashboard. So that's it. Pretty easy, huh? Look for more product widgets and base templates, which are being added all the time. Thanks for watching, and stay secure.